हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच और लेट अस रिवाइज एडिटिंग टेक्स्ट इन वर्ड 2013 चैप्टर 6. ओके, नाउ इन दिस अप टिल नाउ यू हैव लर्न सो मेनी थिंग्स लाइक हाउ टू ओपन दिस डॉक्यूमेंट एंड ऑल. एट प्रेजेंट आई एम यूजिंग दिस विंडोज 10, सो द पाथ दैट इज गिवन इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक इज डिफरेंट. इट इज़ ऑफ विंडोज 2007. So I won't be able to show you that. That's why I have already opened this Word document. Okay, for opening Word document in 7, what you will be doing is you will be going to the Start menu, then All Programs, Microsoft Office 2013, and then you can open the Word 2013. Here the window I am showing is already present. Okay, now when you are opening this document, generally you will get a blank document only, but if by chance you know you don't get this one, what you will be doing is you will going to this file. This is called the file one. Okay, office button or the file button, then new. Okay, if office is not there, here it will be written file. Dono mein se koi bhi ek chalega. So file, new, and you will be selecting this blank document. It is already selected over here. Blank document, select that one, and then over here create. Okay, and a new document will appear on your screen. Now let me type something over here. Let me type class 3 and computer. Okay, and let me take it to the middle of your screen. For that, what I will do, I'll be selecting it and then the center alignment. So what happens, it goes to the center of your screen. Now first of all, let us learn how to save this one. This much I want to save. What I will do, I will go on the top left corner. Please see the cursor. Okay, here save option is there. I will be clicking on that save, and I will get the path how to save. Or else, if you don't want to do this, you can do one more thing. You can do one more thing is that, I'll close this. Over here, file menu or the office button, and here also you get the option of save and save as both. Okay, save as will define the path. I'll click on that one. Now I want to save my document, not in the document section, but in the on the desktop. So I will click on the desktop. Here I want my document to be as it is on the desktop. So the name of my document will be class 3. See, here you can write down the name. If you want to change the name, you can change over here the name also. As if I want to change, I can change it as computer, computer. I have changed the name. Okay, and then click on save. So on the desktop your file is there. Now I want to close the document. I don't want this document on my screen at present. I'm done with it. I have saved and I'm done with it. So I will be clicking on this close button on the right corner, red close button. So this is closed. Now what I want to do is I want to open that document again. So here we had saved it on the desktop. On the desktop computer I can open it. See, the file that we had saved is open. Directly you can open it in this way. One more method to open this document is go to the file, open option is there. You can open it from here also. You can see that here also there are so many options are there. You can open it You can open it directly from here, or else click on open, and then we had saved it on desktop. Yes, remember? So desktop, and then find your file. Your file name was computer. You have to find it. Where is computer? Yes, here it is computer. Click on that and open. Okay, this is another way to open your closed file. Now one more thing we can learn over here is this class 3 and computer. I don't want the same thing as it is. What I want is I want class the size of computer, font size of computer to be bigger than whatever it is represented over here. What I will do, I will select that one. Okay, after selecting, go to this. See, this is the font menu. Okay, here you can change so many things. On the font, I will click on the size. 11 is there. Here small arrow is there. I will click on that and I can change the size. See, in this way. Okay, this much is enough. I am changing the size of computer, which is 24. What I want is the color of this class 3 should be different. I don't want it to be black color. What I'll do, I'll select it first of all. Whatever you want to do, first of all you have to select it. Select it, then here see A. You can change the text color from over here, font color. What is this? This text is called the fonts. They are the fonts. Okay, so I can change my font color from black to red by clicking on this. Now I don't want red, I want some other color. Click on this arrow and you can see so many colors are there. You can select any color that you want. Once more, and there are, see here, one more option of more color is also present, more colors. So I'll click on that more colors and I can select whichever color I want to. Let me select this pink one. Okay, and then okay. So what happens, this one, because I had not selected it, the pink color didn't appear. Again, I'm doing the same thing. This pink color. Got it? So in this way, here also, again, if you want, you can say change the size again. Okay, let me change the size of class 3. We'll go over here. From here, I will change the size as 18. Got it? So that's all for today. Huh. After editing your text, don't forget to save it. So what we'll do, we'll again save it right from here. It is a shortcut key. Save, I'm clicking on it. And then I want to close this document. So click on this red close button and your document is closed. It is saved. Now next time, whenever you are going to open your document, the last thing you had edited will be visible over here. See, on the computer, right from here I'm opening it, and the same thing that you had left in the last session is visible over here. So that's all for today. Thank you.